In this video, you will learn how to install additional themes in Ubuntu 18.04 to make it look different from the default. For example, you can make it look like this, or even like this. You can also change Ubuntu's theme and layout to resemble Windows or macOS 10. Hello everyone, it's Originux User, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and activate the bell notification so you won't miss any new video. Let's install some Ubuntu themes. First, let's start with the simplest, Ubuntu Community theme. This is how it looks. It is available in the Software Center. Simply search for Community theme and install it. Restart your system, and at the login screen, click on this settings icon and select Communitheme session. Your new Ubuntu theme is here. This Communitheme is not complete yet, some icons may be missing, but most of the icons are present, and overall, this theme looks really great. Check it out, I believe many of you will like it. Next, let's install some themes from gnomelook.org. There are themes for everything. You primarily need to look at shell themes, JTK3 themes, cursors, and icons. You can scroll down and see the ranking here. Select what you like. Just make sure the theme is not too outdated. I have already preselected a few themes. The first one is Canta theme. You can read this description on your own. To install it, go to Files and download the theme files. I will download the standard theme, but you can also download some modified versions. I will also download Icons theme and Wallpaper to make this theme look coherent. Go to your Downloads folder and extract these archives. Move wallpapers to pictures. The content of the icons folder needs to be moved to the .icons folder in your home directory. You can also run this script to do the same, but I think a manual way will give you a better idea how to install it. And similarly, the content of the theme folder is moved to the .themes folder. In case you don't find .icons and .themes folders, create them in your home directory. To be able to see hidden folders, in other words folders which names start with a dot, go to Nautilus menu and enable Show Hidden Files. Now, when the themes are installed, you need to select them in settings. But you won't find anything like that in the standard Ubuntu settings. You need to install Gnome Tweaks. You can install it from the Software Center. Let's install it, launch it. Tweaks is a very powerful application. You can change a lot of things here besides themes. But let's focus on theme settings. You can select the newly installed Canta theme for applications and icons. However, as you see here, currently we cannot change shell theme, because user theme extension is not enabled. You can install it from the Software Center. Search for user themes and install it. Restart Tweaks. Now you can select Canta shell theme. Let's check how this theme looks. Unfortunately, not all icons have been changed. This is because Canta uses some icons from Numix Circle Pack. I found this information on Canta's GitHub page. This is the page of the Numix Circle icons. To install it, we need to run these commands in the terminal. Let's do that. Now the icons look as expected. Finally, change the wallpaper. Go to Pictures and select the downloaded wallpaper. Canta theme is complete. It is a very nice theme. Give it a try. Using the same approach, you can install many other themes. For example, have a look at Flat Remix theme. It is one of the most popular icon themes. Sometimes icon and themes can also be provided as dev packages. For example, Masalla icon theme. The installation of such icon or themes is pretty simple. Download the dev packages and install them through the Software Center. I have shown the installation process for Masalla and Flat Remix themes in my Things to Do after installing Ubuntu video. I highly recommend you to watch it. If you are curious, this cursor theme you see is also installed from gnomebook.org by copying the cursor theme into the .icons folder. But what if you don't like having this dog panel on the left? Well, you can move it to the bottom pretty easy, and it will look like this. To get that layout, open Settings and select Dock. Here you can move the dock panel to the bottom. You can also change its size to your liking. The only problem with this layout, the application menu is on the right. Let's move it to the left. You can do it through dconf editor. If you don't have it, install it through the Software Center. Simply search for Show Apps at Top and turn it on. Now the application menu is located on the left side. Okay, this layout still may not be exactly what you want. What if you prefer the simplest layout with a single panel at the bottom, like this one? You can achieve it with Dash to Panel extension, which can be installed through the Software Center. Install it. Now there is a single panel at the bottom. You can go to the settings of this panel and tweak it even further. Personally, what I don't like about this panel is this dash menu. It is cumbersome for this minimalistic style. Let's replace it with a smaller menu. Currently, arc menu is probably the best option. Install it. Here it is. In my view, this menu fits this panel better. You can go to Gnome Tweak Tools and change its settings. For example, you can change its appearance. You can rename it and change its icon. The only problem left is this redundant dash menu. Let's remove it. Go to Extensions and in the settings of Dash to Panel, go to Behavior tab. Disable the application icon. Now there is only one menu button. Finally, add some matching this theme wallpaper and you have a rather classical but modern looking desktop. Many users are also fans of macOS like theme and layout with a top panel and a dock. You can even get a dark Mojave theme on Ubuntu. Do you wonder how? Well, you need to do a few steps. First, let's disable Dash to Panel and Arc menu in Tweaks. Now open Software Center and install Dash to Dock. It is placed on the left side by default. Open its settings and select the bottom position. Next, download macOS icon theme as well as macOS shell and JTK themes. Extract the archives and move them to the corresponding .icons and .themes folders. Open Tweaks and select macOS 11 icons and macOS theme. I have installed only Mojave themes. There are dark and light versions. I prefer light. You also need to change the shell theme to match your application theme. You can also move these window buttons to the left. Go to Windows and select Left Placement. Finally, change the wallpaper and your Ubuntu desktop looks almost like Mac desktop. But there is still a few things you can add to make it look even closer to macOS. For example, you can add fonts and some effects. To do that, I recommend you watching the video by Shivam Ashtikar. He provides many more details on how to get the closest possible macOS look. See the link in the description. What's your favorite theme and layout? Please leave a comment below. If you want to learn more about how to install extensions and themes, as well as some other Ubuntu tweaks and tips, watch my 30 things to do after installing Ubuntu video. Thank you for watching!